Okay, so we're gonna cut the whole perimeter nice and blunt. We took a little more off the back because you have a little more breakage around your face. So I'm just gonna blend the sides into the back. It's a good way to kind of bridge that gap as the sides are growing out. If you take a little more from the back, we're just gonna cut everything blunt here. No point cutting. It's gonna keep it nice and full, looking fuller and healthier for longer. All right. Now let's get into those curtain bangs. A few different ways you can do this. I am going to take a little piece from the front of each side here. We're gonna go just below her nose. See, make sure they're even. So you can either just slide cut to your desired length, or you use your parting section to comb it across, find your guide. Make sure they're even. My biggest pet peeve. I like to cut the interior of my fine-haired clients. When it's dry, you can really see what you're taking from there, so that way you don't take too much. So we have our blow dry done. We did a round brush with some root spray and some volume mousse just to help us out with the volume here. I think we're gonna do the interior of the haircut dry, like I said earlier. We're just gonna add some layering and texture. I'm gonna go in and do this one whole side first so you guys can really see the difference. Get all the tangles out of your client's hair, do a nice little brush through. Then we're gonna go in here and we're gonna start layering. I'm gonna do just a short to long layer here. I'm gonna cut it just blunt. We're gonna get rid of the last like inch of those ends there just to soften it out, give a little bit more volume and lighten her hair a little bit. You also wanna get rid of those crispy ends. They're not really doing anything for you. So I'm gonna follow my guide and go all the way around the hair. I'm just doing the one side first though for now, short to long layers. I also end up taking a crown section and doing a slightly shorter short to long there and point cutting that later on. Here we're gonna add the texture. This is really gonna help push the hair up at the top of the head. I'm doing a little bit of brick cutting here underneath that first layer of hair, but you can see that I'm not going too close to the root, which is very important. So short hair pushes long hair. With the brick cutting here, we are just creating little shorter hairs that are going to push the longer hairs and really help give your client with the fine hair a little bit more hold to their volume when they're styling. So here, just very little point cuts, little bricklaying point cuts. This is something you're definitely going to practice on a mannequin before you go right into regular clients, just to make sure you got the technique down so you're not taking chunks out. But you can see when I push into the hair, that volume stays up at the top above the round of her head, which is the whole point of this brick cutting. So I'm gonna go in from underneath, mids to length, and do a little bit more soft brick cutting. If your client has a little bit thicker hair or wants a little bit more movement throughout their hair and you feel that their hair can handle it, you can go a little more aggressive with some slide cutting there. So now we're gonna help directionally push this curtain fringe away from her face. I'm going in from the underneath, doing some slide cutting, which is gonna push that off of her face there. Perfect. And we've also did a little bit of slide cutting around the face there. You can see that softens and opens everything up around her face, which just kind of blends that into the curtain fringe a little bit. And you can see that with all that texturizing that we've put in there, I'm gonna add a little bit of more brick cutting, slide cutting here. Just opens up the hair a little bit. You can see I'm playing with it a lot to see how it's moving, if it's opening up, if there's certain areas that still feel heavy. This is very important when you're styling fine hair. You really want to make sure it moves and that it's not heavy anywhere. But can you guys really see that difference? How it really opened up her hair? Now that both sides are done, we can see a lot more movement through both sides. The volume in the top above the round of her head is staying a little bit better. She has a little more volume and movement throughout the sides of her hair from all that texturizing. It really opened it up.